This is ancient Sparta, once the greatest military power in classical Greece, now fragmented and cryptic. Can we go home to this? So little survives. Greek literature comes to us copied on papyrus in scarcely decipherable tatters. Face to face with them, we feel these letters come from a world immeasurably distant and remote. There is something forbidding about them. Byron wasn't deterred. With typically highbrow vandalism, he carved his name on the temple at Sunion. Lord Byron went home to Greece when it was still an exotic outpost on Europe's eastern edge. His poetry immortalized a new dream of Greece, which entranced his public at home. They too could return to Arcadia in their imagination. Byron made a virtue of the ruins. The broken stones enhanced the pathos of the past. The world was learning to love the fragment. Keats described a most dizzy pain that mingles ancient grandeur with the rude wasting of old time. But fragments evoke more than pathos. Teasingly incomplete, they appeal to us to make them whole. Greece, which so emphasized perfection of form, seduces the imagination because it is itself a fragment, which each generation finds new ways to reconstruct.
Individuals looking at Greece make different selections of what seems to them important about the Greek world. And when you look at the sort of pictures of Greece that have been entertained over the last few hundred years, you can see that a whole generation can form a certain picture, again, constructed really by picking on certain things which were indeed there, but to which the importance, the priority, is attached by the people looking at them, not necessarily attached by the Greeks.